morning. Good morning. You're welcome to another time of MFC 365. Today is day 204, and we'll be praying prayers for the oil of God. Prayers for the oil of God. Hallelujah. Amen. Starting off today's MFC, that is our prayers with thanksgiving. It is good, it is wonderful, it's an awesome privilege to be able to come into God's very presence. Our Bible says in Hebrews 1 and verse 9, it says, "Thou hast loved righteousness and hated iniquity. Therefore God, even thy God, hath anointed thee with the oil of gladness above thy fellows." Begin to thank God for his faithfulness. Thank God for who he is. Thank God for the benefit of being anointed with the oil of favor. Oh, Marakusia Kataya Baba. Go ahead, pray in the name of
I'm not going to be able to do that.
here. And in this segment, we are praying for our church and our nation. We are praying, I'll be praying for Shouts of Grace Center, and I'll be praying for Nigeria. The Bible says in Psalm 133, verse 1 and 2, in the KJV, it says, "Behold, how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. It is like the precious ointment upon the head that ran down upon the beard, even Aaron's beard, that went down to the skirts of his garment." You will begin to pray particularly for unity, unity in our church, unity in our nation. Begin to pray that God will unite us in the name of Jesus. Yeah. in this segment, we are praying for our pastors, our parents, and our mentors. It is good to lift up these people that have authority over our lives, to lift them up before God in intercession. Bible says in Psalm 89, verse 20 to 21, I have found David my servant with the oil. With the holy oil have I anointed him, with whom my hand shall be established. My hand also shall strengthen him. Go ahead and pray. Pray for your pastors. Pray for your mentors and your parents. Ikaru suse keli barusha kataya baba. Oh mana baba baba baba. Pray that the Lord will establish them. Pray in the name of Jesus. Segment, we are praying for our finances. We are lifting up our finances into the hands of the Lord. If you are a wife, you can pray for your finances. If you are a husband, an individual, you are single, go ahead, pray for your finances. The Bible says in Psalm 23 and verse 5 in the NLT, it says, "You prepare a feast for me in the presence of my enemies. You honor me by anointing my head with oil. My cup runs over." We will lift up our voice this minute and we will pray that God should cause our financial cup to overflow in the name of Jesus. Go ahead, pray. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. in this segment, we are praying for our families. Oh, Maro Sukaya Baba. Families are dear in my heart, and I always like to pray with every mercy in my heart. The Bible says in Psalm Isaiah 61 and verse 1. In the KJV, it says, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. Bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captive, and the opening of the prison to them that are bound. We will begin to pray in the name of Jesus. Every family and my family, in the name of Jesus, God will begin to bind every broken heart in the name of in this segment, we are praying and we are making warfare in the name of Jesus. Bible says in Psalm 89 verse 20 and 21, it says, I have found my servant David. I have anointed him with my holy oil. His enemies will not defeat him, nor will the wicked overpower him. You will open your mouth and begin to pray in the name of Jesus. As I have been anointed, the wicked will not find me. In the name of Jesus, I will not be overcome with wickedness. The wicked will not overpower me. In the name of Jesus, the wicked will not overpower my husband. The wicked will not overpower my wife. In the name of Jesus.
I'm not going to be able to do that.
in this segment. We are praying our desires for the month. Oh, we are lifting up whatever it is that is a burden in our heart, that is our heart cry. We are lifting it to God in prayers. The Bible says in Isaiah chapter 61 and verse 3, to appoint to them that mourn in Zion, to give unto them beautiful ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, that they might be called trees of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, that he might be glorified. We will go ahead right now and begin to pray in the mighty name of Jesus.
I'm not going to be able to do that.
this segment, we are declaring Psalm 91. Psalm 91 is our covenant security scripture, and it is just good for us to confess it before the daybreak, to speak the words of these Psalms ahead of us as we go into today. The Bible says in Psalm 91 verse 1 in the Message translation, "He who sits down in the high God's presence shall spend the night in a Shaddai's shadow." Go ahead, begin to pray. Oh, Mashukataya Baba, that you are kept under the wings of the Almighty. You are protected. You are surrounded in the name of
Shalom,
prayed, hallelujah, in this segment we are making blood declaration, hallelujah. I love the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus answers to every issue, every situation. When you learn to plead the blood of Jesus, the problem is solved. Bible says in the book of Hebrews chapter 12 and 24, it says you have come to Jesus who arranged the new covenant, and to the sprinkled blood that promises that which is better than does the blood of Abel. You go ahead right now and begin to plead the blood of Jesus on as many things as you can remember. The blood of Jesus upon my health. The blood of Jesus. This segment we are praying the Pauline prayers. The Pauline prayers are the prayers that Apostle Paul prayed for the early churches, and if it was good for them, it is good for us now. The Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter 13 and verse 14, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with us all in Jesus' name. Go ahead, begin to pray these threefold prayers, that the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the grace that was upon Jesus that made him do what he did, the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit, begin to pray. Segment, we are praying healing. We are praying for bodily healing. If you are sick in your soul, maybe you are oppressed of the devil, go ahead. If you are standing in for somebody, or somebody is right there and you are trusting God for their healing, let us join our faith together right now. If you have something to connect with your faith, maybe water or cloth or whatever that you drink or send to people, please just get it, because God is a healing God. Bible says in James chapter 5 verse 14 and 15.
I'm gonna get you.
this segment, we are praying for the mercy and the favor of God. Hallelujah. Oh, Bashalala Boshu Kweberele Boshi Kalaba. Bible says in the book of Psalms 139, Psalms 136, verse 10 and 12, it says, to him who struck Egypt in their firstborn, for his mercies endures forever, and brought out Israel from among them. For his mercies endures forever, with a strong hand and with an outstretched arm. For his mercies endure forever. Go ahead and begin to pray. The mercy of God that endures forever.
Glory, glory, glory.
Let us just lift up our hands and begin to appreciate God. Our Bible says that by faith with thanksgiving, let us make our request known unto God. We have done that, and let us begin to thank God for answers to our prayers. For this is the assurance that we have, that when we pray according to His will, He hears us. And if we hear us, we know that our petitions are granted. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, Father, we give you thanks. We so much love you. I prophesy into our lives, into our day, into our family life, into our marriage, into our home. I declare our children shall be goodly and godly. Today, the oil of joy, the oil of gladness is upon us. The favor and the mercy of God is upon us in the name of Jesus. Good morning. God bless you. Have a favorite day. And I expect you same time at 12 a.m. God bless you.